The stage set then for the Gillette Golden Mile. 13 athletes in this mile, and just about to be introduced to the Crystal Palace audience of nearly 20,000. A packed house, not a ticket left, will come specially for this race. Steve Ovett, the world mile record holder, very much the favourite, and one of three Britons in this Golden Mile. Ovett, of course, has won it before. 2 years ago in Tokyo, when the Golden Mile was first introduced, it was won last year in world record time in Oslo by Sebastian Coe. Fontanella of Italy, fifth in the Olympic 1500 metres behind Sebastian Coe. Actually, they've introduced David Moorcroft out of turn. He's the Commonwealth champion. David from Coventry and Ivor Harriers. Next on the roster, the youngest Olympic finalist, 19 years old, Steve Cram of Jarrow in the North East. Steve Cram, already one of the great favourites. And that looked like Wilson Waigwa of Kenya. Eamon Cochran, the world indoor mile record holder from Ireland. Best time, 3 minutes, 52.5. He's followed into the rostrum by Craig Masbach of America. Runs with Harry Gay in this country. Craig Masbach, ninth on the all-time list at 3 minutes, 52.5. Now the American number one, Steve Scott. Not the American record holder yet, but surely he will be someday, taking over from Jim Ryan. Just missed Ryan's best time by 0.01. All-time greats, filled up by Tanzania. Gold medalist in the 74 Commonwealth Games, and he set the then world record of 3 minutes 32.2, and it's only been reduced since over the years by 0.01, 3 minutes 51 seconds there. Dr. Thomas Fessinghager, the West German champion, number four on the all-time world list at 3 minutes 50.6. All-time, we come to the number three of all-time. John Walker of New Zealand. Former world record holder at 3 minutes 49.4. And that, the world record holder, Steve Ovett. And the sign is almost a caption in its own right. Steve Ovett, the greatest. Clearly as relaxed as ever. His world record set this year at 3 minutes 48.8. And also, of course, he shares the world record for the metric mile, 1500 metres, with Sebastian Coe. Well, when this place was sold out, of course, one expected the clash with Coe to take place, but Sebastian Coe, no doubt watching this race, has got a slipped disc. We hope he's recovering well. He won't be out of action too long, and certainly he'll be missed here today. But nevertheless, the British trio, very, very strong indeed. Steve Ovett, the world record holder. David Moorcroft, the Commonwealth champion, and Stevie Cram at 19, one of the fastest teenagers in history. So all ready for the Gillette Golden Mile. Just over four laps of the track. Harry Wilson, Steve Ovett's coach, was saying it could well be a tactical race, but we believe Richard Harris is in the field, number 12, to make the pace if it gets too slow. And Steve Ovett looks to be wearing his favorite lucky Russian vest. So we'll just check the lineup for you from the inside. There in the all red on the inside is Wilson Waigwa wearing number one. Next to him should be Fontanella of Italy wearing number 13 on the drawn order, but that's Eamon Cochran wearing six. Number three, David Moorcroft. Number eight, Stevie Cram. Number 12 is Harris. Number five is Masbach. Number two, Steve Ovett. Number 10, Steve Scott. Number nine, John Walker. Number seven, Bessinghager. Number four, Bailly. And right on the outside, the Lace. The Golden Mile. Four laps. And Fontanella, the Italian, doesn't seem to be a starter. It's Richard Harris, as expected, who's gone off very quickly. Bailly left at the start, moving through on the outside, way back though. In second place, Masbach of America. Third is Steve Ovett of Great Britain. Fourth is Eamon Cochran, with John Walker of New Zealand going up fourth now. And Harris has taken them along at a fair lick. When Steve Ovett set the world mile record, the first lap was running 55.2, and they look to be going very quickly indeed. So it's America 1, America 2, Great Britain 3, Tanzania 4, New Zealand 5, West Germany 6, Ireland 7, and America 8. The American number one back in eighth place is Steve Scott. Scott wearing number 10, and already Steve Pounfelling the pace a bit quick, and so too is David Moorcroft and Wilson Wagon. They come around now to complete lap one. Harris leads for America. Vance back in second place for America. Ovett is third. John Walker, four. Bailly, five. Bessinghaga, six. Steve Tilt, seven. Eamon Coughlin, eight. And Pierre Delays of Switzerland, nine. The time, 55.5, as against 55.2 when Ovett set the world record. And the chasing group not trying to close the gap on the two Americans. It's Masbach now tracking the leader, the pacemaker Richard Harris, and the rest have let him go. They're not interested in fast racing, they're interested in winning. Still Harris way in front now, and Bailly's taking up the chase, and he's not going to let them go too far. Harris now has 10 to 12 metres from Masbach America, then Bailly of Tanzania, Bessinghaga of West Germany in fourth place, Ovett Great Britain five, Coughlin Ireland six, John Walker of New Zealand in seventh place. Eighth is Delays of Switzerland, and ninth is Scott of America. Moorcroft right at the back of the moment, or next to back. And Harris slowing down in front. He's now got 15 metres clear of Bailly to second place. Bessinghaga follows Bailly through. Ovett tracking Bessinghaga. So they go through two laps. 880 yards. The time, 1 minute 56 seconds. Some 3 seconds, or 2.5 seconds outside world record pace. So this is all about winning and not about record. Harris still leading, Bailly in second place, Bessinghaga's third. This third lap is important because they'll surely try and draw the sting from Steve Ovett. Somebody will make a long run from home, and it's Eamon Coughlin going up on the outside. Eamon Coughlin in the green vest of Ireland now hits the front. Strong from 5,000 metre running, but Ovett moved through, ominously fresh in third place. Just stole up on the outside so easily, so relaxed, looking at magnificent form. So the Tony Bailly now, the former world record holder at 1,500 metres, he leads. In second place, Eamon Coughlin. Ovett is third, Bessinghaga Williams joining third place. John Walker closing up on the outside. Delays of Switzerland is there. Moorcroft and Harris right out of it now as they come through three laps, and there's the bell. Just inside the 3 minute schedule, and this is going to be a tremendous battle on the last lap, and Ovett is wide and clear of trouble. Bailly still leading. In second place, Eamon Coughlin. Third is Ovett. Fourth is Bessinghaga of West Germany. Five is John Walker. In sixth place, still improving all the time, the American number one, Steve Scott, and they're punching for the attack. 250 metres left, and Scott makes the break. Ovett goes with Scott, and Ovett fights him off and holds the curve. Bessinghaga looking strong, the West German in third place. Delays is four, John Walker five, and it's Scott, the American number one, and the British world record holder together. Bessinghaga is behind them now. Just over 80 metres to go, and Ovett kicks away in front, and the American struggles. Ovett out and clear. Scott in second place. Ovett looks for trouble, but they're not closing. Steve Ovett wins the Golden Mile for the second time. Second is Scott, and a photograph for third place between Walker and Bessinghaga. The I love you message to girlfriend Rachel goes out. He found that hard, but it was a very fast last lap. It really was quick. 3 minutes 52.9 the time, and I made the last lap for Ovett inside 54 seconds. Well, for once, Steve Ovett is working to the wrong camera, but who cares? This is what the customers paid for, and he did it absolutely right. So beautifully poised. He was always in the right position. Down the back straight, he made the move when Scott hit the front, held the curve on the inside, and he is saying is number one. And my word, what a race it's going to be when a fit Sebastian Coe takes him on again. He's such a durable athlete. And that's, I think, his mum. Mother Gay. And Steve Ovett enjoyed that, as he was entitled to do. It was a very, very impressive piece of running. And the way he kicked and held the curve, kept Scott on the outside, and then kicked again off the final bend, was a sign of the track athlete that Steve Ovett is. He seemed to me to be the master from start to finish. Whenever anybody made of a move, Ovett was there to cover it. Right off the final bend, Ovett had held the curb. Scott must have been hopeful there, the big American, who said earlier in the season that Steve Ovett did too much talking, which is one of the few things he doesn't do. The press don't like it, of course, but Ovett kicked again here and got away. And Scott struggled, but he had the guts to battle back. And you watch Scott, he tried to get back on the inside. Steve Ovett's having a look to see where the danger is, and Scott, for one moment, tries to switch to the inside. But Ovett is clear, and there's going to be no way past him. John Walker finishing really fast. He's in the photograph with Vessinghager for third place. But first, in the Golden Mile, Steve Ovett, Great Britain. Second is Scott of America.